Let's go ahead and create a new Android project and then have a look at the default build scripts. We'll give our app a domain and a location. We'll set a min SDK, and we'll add a blank activity with a fragment. We'll leave the defaults for the fragment. So here we are in our newly created Android app. If we go ahead and haul out the ancient test device and then run our application, let's see what happens. All right, sweet, looks like we're up and running. So let's dive into what Gradle configuration is present by default. Again, the project pane has defaulted to this Android-centric setup, but I find this kind of confusing, so I'm going to switch back to the project view to just show the straight-up project layout. So here's our project, and here's our build.gradle file. There's a whole lot going on in the default Android build scripts. For starters, this is actually a multi-project build, and the Android app itself is a sub-project. We'll talk all about multi-project builds in Lesson 4. But it's set up this way, so it's easy to add other sub-projects that we want to build together with the app, like libraries or even a backend. There are two things to notice in this root build script. First, we declare a build script dependency on com.android.tools.build:gradle:1.2.2. There are two things to note in this build script. First, we declare a build script dependency on this artifact coordinate. This is where the Android plugin for Gradle lives. Second, and we'll talk about this part of the Gradle API soon, but this block adds the JCenter repository to every subproject of this build. That means every subproject can just declare dependencies and they'll automatically be retrieved from JCenter. Now let's take a look at the build script specifically for the Android build, which is in the app directory. So here's the build script for the Android app. Note that it first applies the Android plugin, which it fetched from JCenter. All configuration happens in the Android configuration block. All that's absolutely required are the first two lines, defining the SDK version and the build tools version. The default config block configures attributes of the Android manifest. We'll talk about the build types block momentarily. Finally, the dependencies block works just like Java dependencies. This declares compile time dependencies on every jar in the libs directory and on the Android support library.